First, let me just wish all our ladies colleagues within the chamber a happy Women's Day. Building a strong Singapore society, it is said that if the country's economy is the lifeline of the economy, and the infrastructure is the skeleton of our country, then arts and culture must be the soul of our country. It is the arts and culture that defines us. Through arts and culture, we forge national identity and unites all of us as one people, one nation, one Singapore. As a multicultural and multi-religious society, we have done well to respect and appreciate each other's cultural differences, to practice acceptance and compromise. Yet, the threat of social division and fragmentation can never be completely eliminated. Even as we observe the silver conflicts occurring around the world from afar, we cannot take peace for granted and assume all these problems will not happen in Singapore. This is especially so when there are strong external influences that can disrupt our social cohesion. There have been Singaporeans who were self-radicalized to embrace extremist belief and even wanted to head overseas to support armed conflict or conduct attacks here. Fortunately, in some cases, families and loved ones have stepped in to intervene. Meanwhile, concerns of social divides were sparked following a study that revealed clear divide among social classes in Singapore. Rising living costs and other challenges give rise to problems that may estrange certain groups of people. The cumulative effect of segregation and dissatisfaction can result in an us versus them mentality, which will lead to larger cracks over time. Since MCCY inception in 2012, Singapore has made excellent progress in sports, youth and community sector. Active participation from Singaporeans in these areas have helped to foster a stronger sense of unity and pride. We must continue to encourage greater vibrancy and participation in this sector to create shared experiences, ensuring that our society remains resilient and cohesive. The government is planning to do more at the school levels. But how about the older youths who are more inclined to feel disillusioned? We all want a nation that all Singaporeans are proud to be called home. What are MCCY's strategies to achieve this? How do we measure the strength of our social fabric? What more can we do to strengthen the Singapore spirit and identity?